In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a compression test on your engine. So the first thing is, take out a spark plug. Whatever cylinder you want to test, take out that spark plug. Next, you get a compression tester. These things aren't very expensive. I think this was like 25 bucks or whatever. But you get a compression tester and you screw this side into where the spark plug goes. Now the next step is important. We need to disable the car from starting up. So what we're going to do now is we're going to pull the fuel pump relay so that the fuel pump doesn't run and the car therefore cannot start. So here we are at the fuse box outside. Take it off. There's a little something here. This is fuel pump. And just take out the relay. There. Now the car can't start. So the next thing you do is you go inside and crank the car over, but hold down the gas pedal wide open throttle. And it's important that you do that. So that's what I'm going to do now, and then we're going to come outside and read the gauge reading. Okay, so we're showing about 165-ish PSI. You would look up the exact specifications for your engine, but normally you want it between, like, I don't know, 140 and above. This is what's called a dry compression test. What you would do next, if you were suspecting that the engine has piston ring failure or wear, is that you would take some oil and spray it down. Just put a little bit on the piston in the cylinder. Take out the hose, put this in, put a little bit of oil, by whatever means you can. I just use this because it's convenient. And do this test again. The result, the pressures should go up. But if it goes up a considerable amount, then that's sort of an indication that the piston rings are worn out. So that's all it takes to do a compression test. Thanks for watching.